EMP protection is something that a lot of people have been buying for a long time, especially in the prepping community.
I'm prepping for an EMP attack resulting in total chaos and riots.
For those of you that don't know who a prepper is, it's your neighbor Dave that has a bunkie in his backyard that's completely nuke-proof and is full of canned beans and Spam, carries a shotgun, has 16 Delta Pros and a whole solar array outside in the backyard. And then there's people like Pam who are just actually prepping. They live in Florida, they get hurricanes frequently, things like that. You're trying to just be prepared. The one thing that all of these preppers have in common is that they've always had the fear that if there is an EMP attack, there are thousands or hundreds of thousands of dollars in solar gear and power stations and generators is going to be completely toast. Faraday bags and EMP protection have been bought with solar gear since basically the beginning of solar gear being bought. Always been an added cost to your setup. Turns out though, some good news is that you don't have to buy EMP protection for some of EG4's current product lineup, and hopefully most of their products in the future, because it turns out that some of their gear is already EMP protected by design, which is a massive benefit, and it's free of charge. If you're still here, for the people in the back that don't even know what an EMP is, it's an electromagnetic pulse. It's basically a burst of electromagnetic radiation that can result from both human-made and natural events. Natural events would be more like a lightning strike, solar flare, whereas a human one would be more like a nuclear explosion or other forms of Russian attacks. And so for years, to protect the investment they have made in solar gear, people have been buying what's basically the equivalent of like the heavy suit that you get when you go to the dentist and they put the x-rays of your mouth. Exact same idea. It's like a big heavy jacket for your Delta Pro or whatever other gear that you have, so that when that electromagnetic pulse comes, it basically just can't make it through the big heavy jacket. Point being, if you're off grid and you have like a whole setup and you're not relying on the power grid at all, if one of these attacks happens and say the country's shut down or your state or your town or whatever has absolutely no power, if your equipment survived that solar flare or Russian attack, for example, you would basically still have power. You'd be able to function, harness power from the sun the same way that you were doing so before. Now, we're not really tinfoil hat people here, but with all the stuff that's been going on over the last few years, it definitely feels like an event like this isn't out of the realm of possibilities in the near future. So it's cool that popular EG4 products like the wall mount batteries, the 18K inverter, are already EMP protected. You don't need to do anything extra to protect them. And like I said earlier, it's actually completely free, whereas companies like SOLIX are charging upwards of $2,000 extra. They basically do a process that they call EMP hardening, and it's just using like high density, like thick metals in their products, which obviously everybody should be able to understand. It's like a nice thick piece of metal will keep that pulse from getting through it. And they also do things like putting the actual critical components inside of like an inverter, for example, inside of like a little metal cage in there to add a secondary layer of like insulation to just really make sure that the things that need to be protected are. And they also just basically build into the products like a really high surge capacity, not necessarily for like the output, but the components, the wires, the breakers, that kind of stuff can actually handle a surge of electricity far beyond what it should be able to handle. That way, if said EMP strike hits it and there's a big blast of power, it doesn't just start blowing things up. And they have EMI protecting circuits, which basically just reduces interference of any kind of signals that are going on. It basically, everything that they're doing is like building a fortress instead of building like a shit little mud hut. Obviously, we hope the world doesn't go to shit, but in the event that it does, it's really nice to know that the system that you've already spent a ton of money on from EG4 came protected free of charge, and there's no extra work or involvement or money that has to go into actually protecting your gear. Plus, we just like when companies actually put R&D into their products. We talk about this all the time on the channel. You got some local Texans building quality products, putting research and design and development and testing things and doing it over and over until it's right before they send it to market, which is just cool. Especially in this industry, it's still rare to come by. So shout out EG4 for actually doing a good job. Anyways, that is all we got for you guys. I will catch you guys next time. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.